Found him in with some mighty himself famous.
Sing it. That's Home St. James. Yes, sir. You ever heard of Elmo James? Yeah, he's a blues man. He kind of patterned himself out there. Robert Johnson.
I like the Blues Brothers.
The Blues Brothers.
Hey,
so have you got this in the
extra?
Yeah, I got you right here.
That's your size. Leave your little room for barbecue and everything.
How you like that?
Brother, you can get one?
Yep. The one underneath the blue jumper.
White one?
Yep.
What size?
Blues. Medium. Thanks. Oh, wait on. What's the size on this jumper?
Welcome to Bill Street, Australia, home of the blues, blues, and barbecue.
Here is the Daisy Club, a legendary club. It was formed way back in the early days of B.B. King. All the other famous blues singers. They did a lot of shows. Still on Beale Street, Memphis.
Brad!
Where do I go, huh?
Phone number!
6 007.
Nah.
You're gonna get your photo taken now?
Where's Mum gone? Where's Mum?
It's over there. This is a bus on wheels. Resembles the riverboat point. Now we're looking down the main street in Memphis now. There's sidewalks, gas lanterns, and a lot of shopping districts. Here is a real big black mama. The majority of the population is all black. We're back in Beale Street, Memphis, as we look into the city square.
Just go over there.
And you'll see that the people of Memphis have left a statue in memory of Elvis Presley, the king of rock and roll.
Okay, now let's rock and roll with Elvis Presley. Look at them people standing up there. Them beautiful people. Wonder who they could be.
Statue of a king.
Get a close-up view of them people up there. Oh, who is that? Who can that be? One and only? My moon. Who is that? One of the one and only king of Elvis Presley. Isn't that really good? Look at Nicola, dead to the world. She doesn't like getting her picture taken with Elvis. Too bad now, she's got it done.
Now here on the banks of the Mississippi River in Tennessee, down in there you'll see a boat coming in. That's an oil rig where the crew go out. It's a suspension bridge that crosses all the Mississippi River, Tennessee, down in there. You can see the current in the water is flowing very, very fast. Beside an hotel, which you can walk around, takes you up to the riverbank of the Mississippi River. Say hello to Betty back in Braybrook, Jonas. Tell her you're in Memphis. Jonas! Say hello to Betty in Braybrook. Tell her you're in Memphis. Tell her where you're going tomorrow.
Don't speak, babe, please.
I'm
gonna take a photo
here.
Hello.
Hang on, what'll I get you
here? Oh. Oh. Ah!
Jeez, God, oh bloody mighty, we're in the park. In the park, and here we can see our monkey swinging in the tree. Oh.
Me in the river. What is background?
What it does for a background is...
You're calling me.
What it does for a background is...
Yeah, I get a view.
It's me.
It's me.
It's on me. Right, you hop over there now, Bradley.
Yes.
All right, see Shane? It's on me.
in the river, bended it.
Back on me, back on me, you did. Okay, so over here. Okay, how are you going to start to three?
Needles or anything. Nicola, get up from there. I don't like you sitting on the ground here. Fine. So,
make sure it doesn't kick off me. I'm going to go to it too if it comes back down.
Paintbrush out and they paint it pretty colours and they write Happy Easter on it. I remember being in New York City, they didn't have Easter eggs in shops. They didn't have Easter eggs in Los Angeles. They didn't have Easter eggs in Tijuana.
They
didn't have them in Las Vegas even. That's all I give you. None in the shop windows. And we went shopping in plenty of shops in America. And we went into three shops today in Memphis and they didn't have no shop, no eggs in any windows at all. So I don't know how they're going to have those.
Oh, I know where they are. It's all right, it's all right. I know where he is. Look at me.
And you can't hop that far over, it's too wide.
So he drowns.
He drowns trying to get across here. And they don't have Easter Bunny sleighs. They don't have them. They don't have Easter
dinner is getting cold. You
please, I see everybody at home. The train has to come and eat his dinner.
bus Elvis Presley used privately to take him to his concerts. See Janice making a valiant effort. She's climbing up this big mountain here in Memphis. You can even hear her puffing. Oh yeah, she's doing a fantastic job. This scale of a hill. Very huge mountain. She's struggling now. She doesn't know if she's going to make it to the top. Very big mountain as we look down the side of the mountain. Oh, she's made it to the top. She's put the Australian flag there. Now she's going to try her descent. Wow, wow, yes. This is in the back part of our hotel, which is a park that goes on to the Mississippi River, where the poor end of the town is. And you'll notice that the black population come down here and have a game of basketball. Hotel in Memphis we're staying in. It's a River Bluff Inn. Looks over the Mississippi River. It's 5 stories high.
Thank you. when the Mississippi Delta has been set to begin, stands the classic Peabody bomb, carved from one piece of Italian travertine marble. Although famous in its own right, the fountain is better known the world over because of its residence. If I may direct your attention to the elevator, you will witness a 50-year tradition at the South Grand Hotel, an experience uniquely yours as a guest of the Peabody. Having just left at the house on the transition route to join you, ladies and gentlemen, the march of the Peabody Cup.
Anyway, there was a police station behind the police line train, and the security guard asked right there within 10 minutes. Luckily, she's got the decision. Anyway, they said, I'm going to get her. I'm going to go back to our hospital.
Hey?
I think he had a
recording. You're leaving in just a minute. Before we do, we have some safety rules. We want action of standing in the chair, sitting on the table, or climbing on the safety rails. When going for one...
Hi, Carol Schneider. Do our washing and sort of all those types of things just goes on the American Express card because you've got to hand your card in downstairs and they take the number and everything. So all those sorts of things, well, we'll just get the hotel to do. But where we're staying now, they don't do it. You've got to do it yourself, so I'll do it tonight.
Yeah.
Well, Rich,
we don't see you
tonight, eh? Yeah. We get
up in the bathroom.
Drive over tonight. Yeah, it's half the stuff. We've got 3/4 of the stuff.
San Francisco, That's why we went to this flea market where she was. We went and bought three pairs of LA gear.
Nicole bought LA gear. The one with flowers changed colours. That's right. You've got there.
It doesn't, it's better on the place I'll pay you. It's 20 years. Well, why are we going slow now? We are. Once known as Wolf River, it was dammed off about 3 miles back behind. Now it's a still water harbor, but it's still known as Wolf River. Cops don't know to the left that you stumbled down on to get to the boat that brought across the Atlantic Ocean. Battles aboard sailing ships, then brawled up the Mississippi. At one time, these cobblestones used to be covered with bales of cotton back during the 1800s. Waterway uses their fuel boats and grocery boats to take fuel, oil, grocery, mail, deck supplies, and crew change out to the passing towboats. All the towboats count supplies. Waterway uses the mallet, the jet T, and the lower B to take the fuel flats out to the passing towboats. They use a small red cabin boat to Charlie E. and the Robert S. to take the credit for saving the lives of a total of 32 men, women, and children from drowning. They named this park in his behalf. Tom Lee was a man that never learned how to swim off of some Sunbow River. Traveling 47 feet water. Mississippi is also named as the father of water. Said it was caused from a spark of a train going across the bridge at that time. The fire department wanted to enthuse about taking their equipment onto a burning bridge, so they sit back and watch. In Arkansas, use this side of the bridge. Back from Arkansas into Tennessee, use the other side. The railroad portion of that bridge is still used today. To our left, up on top of the bluff, you see a white stone monument. They went in the towing business for a time. We have about 5 towboats out once in the river right now. Notice this barge here to our left tied off to the bank that was damaged on the front end. That barge was being pushed by a towboat up on the upper Illinois River. The pilot lost control and hit a bridge pier, and that barge caught on fire. It was loaded with petroleum. It did not explode, but you can see that 5 barges long, so he's pushing in what. Towboat and barge to the U.S. District Corps Engineers to do Bangor. At this time, we're going to take a break in the commentary. I want to remind everyone about the concession souvenir stand downstairs. We have cold drinks, hot dogs, popcorn, potato chips, fruit punch, lemonade, a few other snacks on board, and we have a few souvenirs. Feel free to go downstairs and browse around as we take a break in the commentary. Betty and Valerie is downstairs behind the concession souvenir stand. They'll be glad to help you with anything you need. Also, the location of the restrooms are.
While you're steering the boat, he'll tell you which way to turn the boat, all right?
Maybe from Australia.
Yeah, we're from Australia, right?
Right. No.
All the way from Melbourne.
You kidding me, or are you really?
Yeah, we're from Melbourne, Australia. It's dead right. Don't you crush your spate, will you?
No.
All right, then. Okay.
See him?
Yeah.
Yeah.
We need to turn the flash on, or do I need to turn it down there, or leave it right
there? St. Louis, Missouri.
Swimming off the Port Melbourne Pier one day, and it was only about 200 feet across from the pier to the sand. And I used to be able to do that in the swimming pool. I swam about 40 feet and I ran out of breath.
All to our right has all of, with all the wonders in it. That's WREGTV. That's Channel 3 when you're watching TV here in Melbourne. 89 feet of water, 90 feet of water here. 91 feet of water.
And we had about 5 or 6 miles to go.
95 feet of water.
Coming out of churches everywhere. 800 churches.
That'd be about the deepest part of the river we'll get into today. So 95 off this land.
No one wants to
get a lot of questions about how deep is the Mississippi River and how wide is it. That's a very impossible question to answer because they took over maintaining the river and the channels out here. A dike is nothing more than a wall of rocks placed out here.
Goody, you've gone back out to the center. Yeah. Which ones keep looking at me?
They also got a 5,000-seat amphitheater for concerts at night. We got gift shops, restaurants. Oh. Got an excellent museum over there. 18 different galleries inside.
Yeah.
That's real Hollywood engineering. Come on, Steam Arkansas. Steam Arkansas. Well, it looks like something on fire with it. Looks like I got a fire with you on Riverside Drive. Turn over one of these snags with your boat. It will inspect your hull. All the way over to the right on the Mud Island Bank, got a series of numbers on it, ranging from 50 to 100. This will give you the vertical distance between the lowest point of the bridge and the water level. The Solo Bridge, the Upper Memphis Bridge, the New Bridge, the I-40 Bridge, the Big M Bridge, and the Dolly Parton Bridge.
Dolly Parton, oh yeah.
It would be kind of difficult for the towboat style to make it through these sands here, coming through that old channel. So the poor engineers dammed off that old channel over to our left. They got three rock dikes running across that channel, trying to dam it off where that Mother Nature filled that area in with sand. If you look over to our left, in the midst of going to Arkansas, they came on up the river, stopped here in Memphis, stayed overnight, got ready to leave the next morning, went up in that old Tennessee chute, went up in that old chute to our, which is back behind us on the Arkansas shore now.
Thank you.
What cab have we got?
How do you know that's not our cab time?
You said he'd pull up out the front. Melbourne, what we're looking at here is a place where Martin Luther King just got killed. Okay.
heap of rubbish.
Street in Chicago, something that looks pretty familiar from the movie you've seen from the Blues Brothers. Chicago, towards the tallest building in the world, Sears Towers.